welcome back to Transport Fever 2. I am your host, DesertFox. This is Episode 9. We are sitting outside New York, where we just put in the Metroliner. In Episode 8, this is coming off immediately off the back of that recording session. We're just going to kind of keep going here with a little bit of a project I had seen. It's kind of started earlier, but it wants to tunnel now? Now you're going to give me troubles and want a fucking tunnel? I don't want to tunnel this whole distance, but if you're going to make me tunnel a little... Oh, okay, so we're... Multiple sections of tunnel. Not going to fly. Tunnels are expensive, and we have a big-ass mountain range you have to get through. That was a little cheeky. Cool. We're going to set this line up today as a goal. We're going to get the Chicago to New York line pretty much... Oh, that's a goalie, ain't it? We're going to get the Chicago to New York line pretty much built today. In this one. Also, I don't want... No bridge! No bridge, no tunnel. We're saving money. We're going to go with the terrain as much as we can in this. So we have to get... Let's actually come from this side a little bit more. Blow that up. We're just bring that big son of a bitch straight up. Run that son of a bitch right on back. Okay. And go straight. So that has got to go. I will plop something a little further back in its place. Don't know what that was specifically, so I will just do this. And then what tracks? Yep. Now, these cities to the left, they'll get hooked up... basically off of this spine. We'll basically develop a rail network off of this main spine that we're building here. Alright, so passing Toledo. Welcome to the rail network, Ohio. We don't have any stations in you yet, but we will. Just want to, drop in and say hello. So pretty much for those... So this, I think, is supposed to represent either Route 20 or I-94, because I'm pretty sure I-94 runs to Toledo. Might be the toll road I'm thinking of. No, 8094 I think curls up the lake, if I'm not mistaken. Not really been too far east. I've been in New York once. I have been to New York City once before. It was all right. You know, it's New York. Kinda. Very busy. The one thing I'll say about New York that they do not warn you about in the slightest is you are going there on vacation. You're not going there on vacation. And what I mean by that is you are not going on vacation when you go to New York. I thought New York City was pretty. I like architecture. I like big buildings. You know, I like all of that kind of stuff. But... You are not going to New York City on vacation. I mean, unless you are. Unless that's your thing. Unless you got the money to do that. If you do, it's totally you're right and you're calling. But as a Midwesterner heading out there for once, that was an intense experience. Because it felt like work. You know, you got to get up with everyone at, like... You got to meet everyone at a train station. Everyone everyone rides it, you know, a lot of people ride the trains out there. And we were staying in New Jersey for this story. Then, oh, no, that's the right bridge we want. Cool. And we were getting up every day at like 4 in the morning to make the 6 o'clock train. And that's to have make sure you got on the train. You had first dibs to a seat. Trains run ridiculous, but you know, trains run significant numbers out in a big city like that. I'm only complaining because, you know, I'm from... my city's actually only about 40,000 individuals, so... The grand scheme of that, like, that's not that many in comparison to some cities, you know, some neighborhoods that are that, and that's 4 blocks. Like, that actually exists in the world. Like, there's density so, like, neighborhoods so dense, like, my entire city fits, like, the population of my entire city, like, fits into, like, I think someone said something along the fact, here. It's like 40,000 people walk through Times Square every single minute or every of the day. And I was sitting there and I gave that some thought, and there's 40,000 people in my city. So times that, you know, there's 60 minutes in an hour. Shit, let's just do 10 minutes. I mean, that's 400,000 people every 10 minutes walking through Times Square. Now, I'm not sure if this is a completely accurate number. You know, some people like to flub numbers. But, you know, the sheer immense scale to what, you know, you might be used to in your life is completely different to that of a big, big, big city like New York City. And it's definitely a culture shock. And look at that. We have a giant rail line that now spans across almost the entire map. And we did it pretty early. And we still have 87 million to play with for trains. Yeah, signal plopping, not the most entertaining set of material. And I'm thinking, what do we think? Let's look for the fastest train we've got. And then we'll work our way backwards. Oh. sorry about that. So, $110 million to play with. It was a roommate message. $110 million. Let's go buy a turn. Oh, wait. We need to build a line. New line. Gloriously rich blue color. We're going to Chicago? All the way. All the way. We're going to go all the way, brother. Oh my fuck. Line. This is the Chicago to the New York City Express. Now, let's go find us a train. A train, train, train. Favorite part of the episode is buying some trains. So, we do have alcos to do 103. You know, all these alcos do 103. You know, electric, 87, 99, multiple unit. Are we saying the Metroliner might seriously be? No, we might go PAPB. Yeah, I think we are. I'm gonna add one more of them. And that to finish it off. And then we're gonna go. Are those heavier? No, those are. 112 miles an hour? $70 million for a train? Oh, yes, I do. I believe so. Let's go ride that. Look at that. That's a rich blue. And it's going to be a gloriously magnificent train that just thunders up and down this set of lines. Alright, but we have done something very ambitious. I don't think it'll work yet for a while, but you know what? Gloriously ambitious is still ambitious nonetheless. And I will take gloriously ambitious over not ambitious at all. And who knows? It might take a little while to get it rolling, get it paying, but I'm assuming that when that train gets to that other end of the line, there will be some passengers. Well, one can hope. Alright, but either way, I've been your host, the Desert Fox. I'm going to leave you guys here with that. I'm going to let that bed in. I'm going to go have some lunch. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Next one, we will probably start working with some ships. We will get a steel mill set up. We're going to get steel moving. We're going to get the Midwest Steel Belt kind of rolling here. The Chicago, Indiana, Northwest Indiana Steel Belt to Detroit will get set up. And we'll start getting some cars. The next series of episodes will all be freight-oriented and getting some freight massively produced. But I just want to show you guys one last time. Like, we have, like, cross the map to cross the map, handled everything. So I've been your host, Desert Fox. Please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.